like, you know what? I might need to break this into two parts. I hate rushing, especially in ASMR. It's supposed to be calm, 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 and relaxed. And I really like to be able to talk about each item. So, without further ado, why don't I just get started? Also, really quick, if you aren't already subscribed, this is gonna be a collective haul from Temu, Sephora, and Ulta. What should we do first? I kind of feel like we should do the Temu stuff first, because it's mostly really cutesy Hello Kitty Sanrio stuff, and I'm really excited about it. Why don't we start off with this giant blush? try to be in the moment, ground yourself, take some deep breaths. I know that sounds cliche, but I find grounding myself really tends to help. Just feeling my feet on the ground, that kind of thing. Okay, should we move on? Next. Oops, there's hair in it. Sorry, guys. I got this precious My Melody, and I don't know who this is. I'm so sorry. She looks like a little pink sheep. Show you. I got both plastics or silicone ones. I guess they probably are. I don't know. A little bit on the flimsier side, but they're really just for the aesthetic, not for the protection. So this one might be a little bit sturdier. I haven't actually opened it yet. And it comes with a charm. For like a one doesn't work. This one looks similar to my last one. I have the smaller black one that I'm using now, so I think we're all good to use the big mics now, which I'm overjoyed about. Let's see what else we've got here. Oh, really quick. I don't know if these are children's size. No, I feel like they'd work. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Hello, 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 hello. But they're Hello Kitty masks, if you haven't been able to tell yet. Face masks. And I know we're not really wearing masks anymore. Where the general population, I think you can say, has for the most part stopped wearing masks. And, like, that's totally up to you, whatever you want to do. But I still occasionally like to wear them. And I especially need them for work. One of my clients, I'm in her personal bubble a lot, so I always wear a mask. So I thought these would just be fun for work. Something about, I think, like, people loving cats, but they did their best. It doesn't really bother me, I just got a little chuckle out of it. I don't speak Chinese, so I have no right to judge. I'll still use it. Who cares? No one's gonna be reading up close to my phone anyway. I guess I should say Sanrio because it's my melody. Yes, purple. I know I've seen some makeup collabs, and they usually make chromey. Yeah, I think it's chrome. The packaging purple. So I think her box is purple. If that's something that interests you more. Thank you. struggled in college with BV. I hope that's not TMI, but I think many layers of skin off. I hope that doesn't sound like gross or scary, because they've never even close to made me bleed or raw or anything. They're literally just taking the dead skin off. There's that much. I'm outing myself on me, at least. But sometimes I don't want to do my whole foot because it's mainly the heel. So, I thought these would be nice to have. Give those a whirl. And then, I think the last two Ulta products are these hair products. This is not a hair product. It look kind of looks like one, so. This is the Morphe Luminous Setting Spray. Spray Fixateur Illuminateur. Terrible French. I don't know why I do that to myself. But it says set and glow. Set liquid and powder makeup with a fresh, smooth, glowing finish. This micro fine mist. See, I love that. Infused with coconut water, apple extract, and glycerin. Love glycerin. It's the reason I actually got this when I saw it had that in it as one of the first ingredients. Instantly hydrates skin and provides long-lasting moisturization while applying a sweat-proof, humidity-proof, performance-enhancing hold. Bit of a mouthful there. Smells so good. A little bit coconutty, just like very spa and fresh. Oh, I like that. There's nothing I like more than a good facial spray. And it is a very fine mist. Would you like to try a little? Yeah, sure. Here we go. Feels nice, doesn't it? Okay, last but not least from Ulta, I'm wanting to, I don't know, I might keep this a little bit longer, but I bought this color depositing mask in the shade Rich Chocolate Brown by IGK. It gets really good reviews. I think I want to go back to my natural color or as close as I can get and just, I've said this before in one of my videos, at least one of my videos, but I'm really on a hair journey right now. I want to grow my hair as long as I possibly can because I bleached it and dyed it for so many years. So I really don't want to have to bleach or color this again once the red washes out because it's just a temporary Arctic Fox shade. But I thought this mask would be a nice, like, two-in-one conditioning, and just if I use it slowly over time, hopefully it will change my hair a little more brown. But I, again, didn't want to go in with anything from Sally's or, like, a box dye or anything, so I thought this might be a healthier way to slowly go back to my natural shade. Sprays on the market. I don't know what's going on with my hair. Sorry, guys. It's annoying me. It gives me tingles when people adjust their hair and stuff in videos. But that's probably not the case for everyone. I wanted to leave the packaging on this, the plastic, because I thought it would make a really nice peeling sound. Because I really wanted to try it out when I first got it. But is just delectable. So, I wanted to try this one and just get a little more of this as well, so that's why I got her. Okay, last review item. I have heard so many things about this Juliet Has a Gun brand. And I think it's the original scent. Of the vanilla vibes scent and had to give this a try. I'm so dramatic. I have so much perfume. I really should do an updated perfume collection because you guys always seem to like this. It comes in this foam. It feels kind of fancy. Packaging. I think smaller size, and it was probably twice this size, and it was close to $40, I think. This is their molecular repair hair oil. Oh my god, I'm so sorry about the lawnmower, guys. I really hope it's just like very slight white noise on the background. This sounds very liquidy and lightweight, so I'm excited to try it. My hair gets weighed down very easily by oils. Really, the only oil that I found, or the two oils that I found that don't weigh down my thin hair, are the... Oh, also the whey, I think you pronounce the whey oil, I really like, and it smells like lilacs. I like the... Why am I totally blanking? It was the Verb hair oil. You get more bang for your buck. So I would definitely recommend that. I mean, I've never tried this one before, so maybe it's incredible. I'm speaking too soon. Okay, guys, last product. If you've made it this far, I love you. Thank you. This is a repurchase. I've purchased this at least twice, I think. It was previously advanced retinoid emulsion. The Ordinary has really like revamped their brand and changed the packaging and names and prices. Unfortunately, they used to be super affordable and now they're kind of middle range, I'd say. But I do really like this for a nice gentle retinoid. Like the fresh new skin from underneath to the surface. That's why it's advertised as being so good for fine lines and stuff. So, I mean, don't quote me on it. I'm not a cosmetologist, obviously, but this is the one thing that I do for anti-aging. I know I'm only 25, but figure may as well start now. Doing these collective style hauls. It's just fun to go